Hello, and welcome to today's video presentation on enabling KVM on Oracle Linux 8. In this video, we will provide a background on KVM, show how to verify the KVM modules are loaded, install the virtualization packages, and validate the environment is ready to host VMs. So let's get started. Kernel-based virtual machine, KVM, is an open source Type 1 bare metal hypervisor. This functionality permits a host system, such as Oracle Linux 8, to host multiple virtual machines, VMs, or guests when running on supported hardware. These VMs use the host's physical hardware to virtualize an operating system as a regular Linux user space process. The KVM code was first announced in 2006 and merged into the mainline kernel as part of version 2.6.20 in February 2007. Therefore, KVM is part of Linux. It implements a host kernel module along with a processor-specific module that supports x86 hardware with virtualization extensions, Intel V8 or AMD-V. There are several benefits of using KVM in the enterprise. KVM uses a combination of Security Enhanced Linux, SE Linux, and Secure Virtualization, SVERT, for enhanced VM security and isolation. KVM can use any storage supported by Linux, including some local disks and network-attached storage, NAS. KVM implements nested virtualization or running a VM inside another VM. Although it is possible to manually manage a handful of VMs running on a single workstation without a management tool, large enterprises traditionally use virtualization management software. That software interfaces with virtual environments and the underlying physical hardware to simplify resource administration, enhance data analysis, and streamline operations. Oracle has Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager for this exact purpose. More details on Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager is available in the Oracle documentation or Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager training. Now that we have a general understanding of KVM, time for getting it running. For this demo, I use a bare metal Oracle Cloud instance patched to Oracle Linux 8.2. For physical or on-premise systems, use the same steps. Connect to the system's terminal and validate that the hardware supports virtualization. For Intel systems, type grep space minus e space single quote vmx single quote space /proc/cpuinfo. For AMD systems, type grep space minus e space single quote svm single quote space /proc/cpuinfo. If you do not know your CPU type, you can type grep space minus e space single quote vendor underscore id single quote space /proc/cpuinfo to get this information. This system is Intel based, shown by the output of genuine Intel. It also supports virtualization by the existence of the VMX flag. Next, check for the loaded KVM modules. Type lsmod space pipe space grep space KVM. The output display is the KVM kernel module and the KVM underscore Intel processor module based on this system's hardware. These modules should load by default on modern Linux systems. Now that we know the system supports virtualization, we need to install the software packages associated with the Oracle Linux 8 virtualization module. Type sudo space dnf space module space install space vert. This command installs the collection of virtualization packages which include libvirt, qemu-kvm, and other dependencies. To display the details of what the module installs, run sudo space dnf space module space info space vert. Next, install vert-install and vert-viewer by typing sudo space dnf space install space vert-install space vert-viewer. That completes the install of the required set of packages. Validate the host machine is ready and set up to run libvirt VMs by typing vert-host-validate. Note that libvirt is an open source toolkit for managing virtualization platforms such as KVM. If all checks pass, then the system is prepared to create VMs. If any checks fail, follow the instruction to correct the problem. If any check returns a value of warn, then consider the following instructions to improve the virtualization capabilities. If you get the message QEMU, checking for hardware virtualization, fail, only emulated CPUs are available, performance will be significantly limited. then creating VMs will fail rather than have performance problems. Next, start the libvirt-d daemon and enable it to start on each boot automatically. Type sudo space systemctl space start space libvirtd.service. Then, sudo space systemctl space enable space libvirtd.service. Lastly, check the service status with sudo space systemctl space status space libvirtd.service. The libvirtd service is now running, and we are ready to create VMs. Thank you for watching this video, and enjoy using KVM on Oracle Linux 8. Please check our additional information on Oracle Linux 8 in the Oracle Linux 8 documentation or Oracle Linux Learning Library.